follow through.
Hey guys, it's TunaGuy23. Doing a bit of an update. I haven't done a vid in maybe a week, I guess. Figured I'd do a little session. I'll show you right now. You see right here, I cleaned his cage. Bought a couple like poster boards, two blacks, two greens, two blacks on the sides. One of the green ones in the back, you know, put his greenery up top so he can climb. Here he is right down here. He wants out. He's been hopping up and down, yeah, up right here, right around the door, telling me that he wants out, but I'm not letting him out just yet. He needs his fights. As I said, I cleaned it out yesterday. The thing was dirty. Lights back on. Then over here, I have a 10-gallon, which I had some fish in it, but one of them actually died, which was an algae eater. He died, and so I put the two goldfish back in the little 3-gallon. Cleaned the 10-gallon out. Put a little bit of reptile bark in there, and put a little reptile, like little tree thing, and folded it all down. Next time I clean this one, he's gonna go on that while I clean it. So that way he does get some light and he's not out, where he's not gonna get any light. And I cut a cardboard to fit. It fits real good. It's good and snug. Got a little green thing here. This is just a piece of poster board. I'm gonna try and make like a schedule of what to do. I haven't really had a schedule. Kinda just, you know, I cleaned it yesterday, so yesterday was like 17th, I guess. Put my little thing right here. That way I know what the next time to do is cage, you know. So anyway, little 3-gallon. It ain't much, but you know, I don't care. It's something for the fish instead of being in that thing. Cause that, for some reason, this is a 10-gallon tank, but yet this pump, this. Damn, now I can't think. My mind drew a blank. This works better in the 3-gallon than it did in the 10-gallon. Even now, this says it fits. 3 to a 10-gallon, but apparently this one, I'm gonna have to, if I do go with another fish, I guess I'll have to go with like some kind of a pump that fits a 15-gallon, which will work alright anyway. But yeah, next time he's getting it cleaned out. Next time he gets it cleaned out, he's going in there. That's pretty much what the update is about. You know, I clean his cage and put some poster board up. That way he can't really see himself in the glass. But I think he sees himself just a little bit, but not much. Get a full range of this. Yeah, this is 10-gallon next to him. Goldfish next to that. Pretty much it. But I was curious, like Rudy, Leopard Gecko Fry. You said, actually, I can't remember. I think a 10-gallon I can hold a leopard gecko, right? Just because I couldn't remember. Pretty sure I can hold put one in there. This is a 10-gallon. Or I could put, I don't know, like scorpion or a tarantula. But, yeah. Anyway, oh, I have another video that I am going to upload after this one. It was a, it's called a broadhead skink. They, pretty, that's the first time I've seen one down here, because I've been down here in South Carolina for like past 4 years, and I've never seen one in the wild, but I took a video of them, yeah, it was yesterday, and, so gorgeous skink, so, hope y'all look at the other video with skink, it was gorgeous. And TunaGuy23 signing out. And I hope y'all like it, comment, subscribe. Got any answers for me for what I can put in a 10-gallon tank? I know I can put a leopard gecko. Pretty sure I can. I think that's what Rudy got his in. Let me know. You know, leave me a comment. This and that. Da da da. And this is TunaGuy23 sign out. I will catch y'all later.